Hi, I'm Phil Malto, and welcome to Snowmobiler Television. On today's episode, I'm in the Grey Bruce region of Ontario. This area is known for very tight trails, some very wide trails, and some very twisty trails as well. It's also known for getting lots and lots of snow. And later in the show, we're off to Cain's Quest in Labrador, where the racers are getting ready for the home stretch. And also on today's show, I'm in Gravenhurst, Ontario. I'm trying out some tight trail grooming with the Bear Cat Groomer from Articat.
STV is sponsored by Yamaha, revs your heart. Kimpex, fueled by fun. And by Skidoo, never stop pushing.
As the host of Snowmobiler Television, I have the opportunity to ride in many different areas that showcase many different types of riding. When it comes to trail riding, my favorite kind is the tight, twisty trails. Here in Grey Bruce County, they've got that and much more.
You should come to Grey County because of our abundance of snow. So because we're located around Georgian Bay, the lake effect provides us with, as I say, a lot of fresh powder. Annually, we receive over 9 feet of snow, so that obviously provides a lot of base. We do have freshly groomed trails, and the nice thing about Grey and Bruce, over the fact that we've got 3,600 kilometers of trail, we have a wide variety of smaller communities that are a great base. They have a lot of tourism businesses that are geared towards snowmobilers, so they're snowmobile friendly. Because we are located by the Niagara Escarpment, we have some wonderful offerings while you're on trail. You can be riding and you'll see a nice outcropping, which you can get some beautiful panoramic shots from. Because of our Niagara Escarpment positioning, we also have a lot of waterfalls within Grey County. So as you're riding, you've got some waterfalls that are very close and nearby. We offer a lot of variety. So our trails, we have some densely forested areas, as well as some rural, you know, landscapes with barns and stuff in the background. But we also offer our District 9 maps. They can be very helpful while you're out on the trails.
Well, Grey Bruce has the most diverse trails that you'll find in all of Ontario. Everything when you get up the peninsula, riding along the cliff face and the escarpment as your backdrop, and you can experience driving through waterfalls. With all 3,200 kilometers of trail, there's plenty to see and experience while you're here. Yeah, well, when you're getting up the escarpment, you have some trails are high and some trails are low. So with Lake Huron on the west and Georgian Bay on the east, we get quite copious amounts of snow. So we're not lacking snow up here by any means. The terrain, the trails are kept really well groomed for riding, and very tight turns for some places if you're not cautious, and some great trail riding all around. And you can get off the sled and just see the escarpment as you drive by Skinner's Bluff. Lots of turns and lots of snow.
Grey Bruce, to me, is a combination of two things. And one is lake effect snow. So we generally get extremely good snow conditions derived off the lakes. And the second one is what I call the spaghetti network of trails. We have trails running everywhere. So you can do, if you want to go out for 2 hours with your kids, if you want to go out for 3 days with the guys or the girls, there's just literally trails that run everywhere that provide so many options that all connect into funky little restaurants like Ted's Range Road Diner, down in Markdale, over to Southampton. There's just so many options that you can stage at a one location and you can ride three different directions, you know, all in one trip. Yeah, we get a lot of people from Southern Ontario here because we're really the first significant snow destination. And this year, you know, especially, you know, we got a lot of early snow. Trails were delayed like everywhere else, but now we're still getting a lot of Southern Ontario riders, and it's because you have so many options to ride. It's not like just riding one big loop. You can ride multiple loops on multiple days, and that's what the big attraction is.
District 9 is absolutely a wonderful place to snowmobile. We run from Tobermory all the way down the Lake Huron shoreline to Godrich, across through Listowel, over to Fergus, back up to Thornbury, and then up the Georgian Bay shoreline. So encompassing all of that area, you get fabulous places to ride. Everything from beautiful, turny, windy bush trails to open farmers' fields that are hilly and wonderful and lots of fun, to some flat stretches. Just, you cover so much different terrain all in one day that you never get bored riding in District 9. A lot of people think they have to trailer north to get great trails, and you really don't. Our snowfall is phenomenal. Our trails are beautiful. They're diverse, and for most people in that GTA, Hamilton, Golden Triangle area, great snow is a lot closer than you think.
It's a mix of lots of different types of trail. There's some rail line that runs right through the middle of it, quite busy. Sometimes quite nice, sometimes a little rougher because it is so busy. We've got some farm field trails, we've got some bush trails. It's pretty scenic. A little bit of road running here and there, but for the most part, it's a pretty nice trail system. The Saugeen River winds through our area all over the place, so you quite often coming up beside it, and it's tranquil. You get to see lots and lots of wildlife, deer and turkeys, and you name it. It's a pretty neat experience. The entire district, I think, all of southwestern Ontario is quite similar that way, especially with agricultural areas where you've got large fields that obviously you can get out and you can ride for a mile or a mile and a half. Straight with, you know, visibility is 360 degrees and you can clip right along, but then as soon as you come to the edge of that field, you're right back into a bush area that quite often is a maple bush or that kind of thing, and you don't be cutting trees in a maple bush, so the trail winds its way through and it makes it a little more of a challenge, and you have to slow down and you have to drive to the conditions. Most riders are quite good at that.
Yeah, snowmobilers that trailer or ride in have everything at their fingertips here in Owen Sound. We have easy access to gas stations, restaurants. There's a restaurant on site. The whirlpool and hot tub area are perfect for relaxing after a long day of riding. You can do loops out of Owen Sound and loop back to the hotel, or you can park your trailer here and make it to other destinations for the evening.
Great trails like this just don't happen. Dedicated snowmobile clubs and volunteers make these incredible conditions possible.
It's a huge area to groom. The clubs really are the grooming experts in their own area. Like we talked about before, District 9 is extremely diverse, and each area has its own grooming specialists that really understand that area. So they know when to go out, they know how to pack, they know how to build a trail. We always say anybody can get in the cab and drive a groomer. District 9 groomer operators really understand what it takes to build trail in their specific area.
Feeling a little deja vu, it is Team 00 who returned back into Goose Bay for the second time at 4:14 a.m. 6 hours later, Teams 73 and 59 rode in together to fill the top three positions after a hard and fast ride down from Postville, which we are sure came with a sigh of a relief in leaving the brutal conditions of North Coast behind in the snow dust.
Not too bad. Voisey Bay is very rough, but once you got down on the Hopedale area, it smoothened out and very, very fast down the coast last night. Great ride, actually. It was very enjoyable. Not like today. You can't see no bumps today. That's why I just cut my tongue, huh?
Coming down last night, it was ideal. We were cooking. Coming down, everything was, well, there's some bumps, but it was a lot better than what it was the night before.
It's not so bad down here, but further north now, it's unreal. You can't go a skidoo length without hitting a bank that's hard as concrete. The whole way right from in the lake here, and once you get other side, right from the Billy Catters in Postville right to the Billy Catters in Maine. Just bang, 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 bang the whole way. It's a wonder the skidoos are holding up.
I feel terrible, honest to God. We couldn't ride this morning, I couldn't function. A couple little boys wanted to race, and the hell with that. No racing for me.
Yeah, limping in reminded me of that 2008. My shocks my Yamaha went. And now it's doing the same spring. Bang, bang, bang. Every bump.
Well, it's all blurry now, man. I don't know.
It's forever. Like, it's the big land, right? It goes on and on and on and on. I don't know. It's there's a few brooks open. Where we went by where Wayne, is it Wayne? So we got to see that little hole, but it's forever. Like, it's from Nain to Goose Bay is a long journey, especially when you've had no sleep for a week.
For Jason King of the Backcountry Ravens, Team 77, it was an extra special celebration as his son awaited his arrival in the compound, proudly cheering on his dad with support.
It gives you that warm and fuzzy feeling. I think I was telling you about there last week. Same thing. Yeah, it's nice to have support. We've had great support all up the North Coast, in particular Hopedale. They treat us really, really well there.
As the teams come closer to the final stages, the alliances, like 73, riding with 7, 17, and 59, will soon be put aside, and it will be each team for itself.
Well, you know, it's been a restless night for all of us, I think. Coming down from Nain there, certainly... must have been a challenge for many of them, many of the riders. We're quite happy that the Super Sevens, I call them, they stay together. But at some point, I guess we have to part, and each of them take on the new challenge. And I think from maybe from here in Goose Bay on to Lab City, I think you'll see some changes along the way, sort of thing. But we're quite happy with the progress that all of the teams are making, and. For those that are left in, kudos to them, and hopefully they'll have a safe ride from here to Lab City.
With a 6-hour lead, Team 00, the NU Hawks, were the team to catch, but their strategy was simply focused on navigation.
Don't lose track. If we lose track, we're in trouble. So we got tracks all the way to Lab City, to Esker 2, which is big help. If we lose the track with battery dies, we're in trouble, real trouble. So we're going to try to keep ahead all the time.
It'll take a mechanical breakdown or a major flaw in their mapping, which I don't expect because they've already ran this route once, so I imagine they have the track. So it's just a matter of those guys just got to glide through, and they got it.
Only 10 teams remain in the race after the beast that Cain's Quest is has forced 19 others to scratch. Wasting no time, exactly 8 hours after arriving in Goose Bay, the race leaders, Team 00, get back on the clock and head out under some decent skies to tackle the last chapter of the competition. Some serious drifting keeps them awake as they cross the lakes and rivers towards Churchill Falls. More and more, the route brings them along brooks with open patches that always keep the pilots guessing as to which route will be the best. Sadly, it was one of those left or right calls that would get the best of Team 00 as the lead sled breaks through and gets stuck along the riverbank. Many efforts are made to get the sled unstuck when the decision to pull the sled sideways towards open water results in a racer dropping through the ice and soaking himself in the freezing cold water. This dip in the drink, combined with suspension damage, would force the leaders to not only lose their massive 6-hour advantage, but it would push them to scratch and end their journey. When snowmobiling as a duo or as a group, communication with the other sledders is key. Today I'm going to show you a product that helps you stay in communication with the other sledders that you're riding with. Here at Snowbuilder TV, the product that we're trying out is the Uclear Communication System. Inside the box, when you open up your packaging, there's two full sets, instructions, all the adapters, power that allows you to charge off the wall or off a regular USB. Also in the kit are your two systems. This is what it looks like outside of the helmet, and this is what it will look like when it's mounted to your helmet, and inside is where you put the two receivers, and your microphone are also attached in there. So it comes complete with everything you need. This is the communications device that clips to the side of your helmet. It slides on and snaps on so it can slide anywhere along your helmet. As you can see by the flashing blue light, this system is active and is talking to the other system. To work, it comes through these two headphones via this cable, which is also the same cable connector that you'll use to charge the system off the USB or off a wall plug. So you simply plug that back in, and that is how the two speakers and the microphones are connected. Now this system comes with two, but you can actually set these up in a series so every rider can be on the same channel and relay the signal back and forth amongst the group. As you can see on my helmet, I have the Uclear transmitter receiver clipped to the jaw area of my open face helmet, and that goes to the two speakers, which Velcro easily into any helmet. There's your speakers and also your microphone for communicating to the other people in your group. Simply clip that on to the edge of your helmet, wherever you would like it. Slap that on, and this other unit, the Uclear, simply slides on over top. So the earpiece microphones simply slip inside your helmet. They attach with Velcro. I've got two helmets now that are set up. They're powered up. They're synced together. And we're going to go for a ride and have a conversation. Communication was very clear during our ride. Installed properly inside the helmet, this system delivered great rider-to-rider communication, and the system can do much more than that. The technology allows multiple riders to be linked in so the entire group can listen to the lead sled or the person in the rear. This helps eliminate the unnecessary group stops at every intersection or trail condition change. If everyone is good to keep riding, there is no need for trailside meetings. Another benefit to this system is the ability to utilize Bluetooth technology and accept calls while on the trail. This is a benefit to those folks who need to be in constant communication with family members, or it's imperative for work scenarios. It also means no more digging for a cell phone in inner pockets. While riding with the Uclear system, I was impressed with the quality of the signal and the ease of operation. The controls are very glove-friendly. When I have been out riding over the years, I've noticed letters with communication devices, and I've pondered the useful applications. After my test with the Uclear kit, I could see the usefulness in many situations. Riding with new sledders would be improved, as you could coach them from another sled while they gain confidence riding solo. Riding with people who had young passengers would be simpler, as adults could easily relay the fatigue or cold conditions of these younger passengers. Riding with experienced snowbuilders would also benefit in navigating trails. It could let an observant rider inform the others when they may have missed a trail marker. The use of Uclear can help eliminate the scenario where a sledder may have a mechanical issue and the person in front rides another 3 kilometers before noticing their absence. The Uclear benefits are really starting to add up. And lastly, there's the ability to listen to music while riding. Hey, why not? There are a lot of clubs that got smaller access trails. Some of them are only 4 feet wide, and grooming them can be a bit of a challenge. Articat came up with the answer.
Well, this is the 2015 Bear Cat Groomer Special. It's specifically designed for to pull a drag and to fit those narrow trails where the big groomers can't go. It's specific for ski trails. You can use it in snowmobile trails. There's all sorts of utilities you can use it for. We already had our utility sled, the Bear Cat. We knew it was a fantastic machine, especially with that 1100 four-stroke engine. And we saw the need for a utility sled that would be able to pull a drag into the small, tight areas. So the Bear Cat Groomer was born, a little bit wider track. It's got an 18-inch track on it. It pulls it well. There's a winch attached to it, so in case you get stuck, you can winch yourself out. A little bumpy coming in, but once the groomer passed, it was fantastic. It got into tight spots where the big groomers can't get into. And we even got a few comments from snowmobilers on the lake on how great the trails look this year compared to last year, just with a few passes of that groomer. You know, some of the bigger trails, of course, it wouldn't satisfy because it's a 4 foot wide groom. But a lot of the connecting trails that connect to the larger trails, you'll be able to groom those, some that I've never seen a groomer before.
Every region and every trail is different. When clubs and resorts have tight trail systems where larger groomers cannot operate, their Bear Cat package is ideal. Not only can it get through these challenging, rough trails, but can also groom across wetlands where larger, heavy groomers dare not travel. Easy on the budget, easy to operate, and even fun to operate, this Bear Cat package is an ideal grooming option.
STV is sponsored by Ultimax Belts, performance proven, performance driven. Triton Trailers, the difference is in the details. And by CKX, wear your passion.
I've really enjoyed my stay here in Owen Sound these past few days, riding on some really incredible District 9 trails. The tight, twisty trails and the deep snow did not disappoint. On next week's show, we're off to Whitecourt, Alberta. We'll also drop into Labrador for the final stage of Cain's quest, where the snow is getting really, really deep. Then we're going to flip the weather 180 degrees. We're also going to check out some summer grass drake action. I really enjoy your input and your comments, so email me, Phil@snowmobilertv.com. Thanks for watching.